Hey guys, this is Joel here from joelwebsites.com. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the SQLite database. So the SQLite database will help you create a database for your Android app. Especially if you're creating an app in Cordova, this database is going to be very useful. So in this video, I'll just show you what code has to be written to set up this database and how you can execute queries to the database like select statements and insert statements or update statements. So stay tuned guys and keep watching this video. So guys, following is the code that will help you create the MySQLite database. Okay, so first of all, there you have to just write this function db helper and window.open database. So this is the basic thing that will help you create the database. This is just a simple JS file. You just need to include it in your Cordova project and it will help you create the database. Suppose if you use the same thing on Google Chrome, you will find the database that is created in the console section. Okay, so here you will find it. If you press F12, you have to press F12 and it will open this tab. Then you have to go to resources and then here you will see some new database created. Okay, so it should be in this index.db. You will find it in WebSQL. So suppose if you are running the Cordova project on your computer or using a browser, then here is where you will find it in WebSQL section. So you have just defined two functions, that are success db and error db. These are the other ones are repetitions. I will now show you how they are used in the queries. Okay, so here I have just created a new normal JS function that is sync answer table. So basically it is calling my server. There is a post call to my server. And then there is a select state, there is a create table. Okay, so here is a create table. This part is a create table statement. This is how you execute queries. Okay, so this is an example of create statement. So here is it. So guys, I will provide you this code in the description. Okay, I will mention this code in the blog post, so I'll attach the file below. So be sure that you will get the file. If you have any doubts or question about this code, then don't forget to mention it in the comment section. So here is an example of the create statement. You have to just insert the create statement over here. It's simple. So let me show you another example. Here is an example of delete. Okay, basically what happens is that this tx.execute has to be inside this db helper thing and you have to execute a query, and basically this function returns an error db or success db that I have already shown you on top. So if there is an error, you can call it, will error db will be called or success will be called. Okay, these are this error and success functions. These are just some commented code. So here I am showing you an example of the select statement that I have created. So basically what happens is that there you have to just define a variable. You can just create a string variable that contains the SQL query, and then in the end I have used this SQL statement over here. Okay, see, the same variable is over here. And then I'm just there is a simple for loop that iterates the result set, and then accordingly you'll get the value. So here I'm just iterating the value. You have to make sure that the column name is over here set properly. So this is a simple select star statement. Okay, when in the where clause there's a like statement. Similarly, this function too has an error db and a success function. This is the error and this is the function. This is a success. Okay, So if there's any failure in the query, it will go in error, otherwise it will go in success. So this is how it is really simple to create the SQL code, okay, for MySQLite database. For MySQLite database, you can use this in your Cordova apps. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video.
So guys, if you like this video, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and write a comment below about your thoughts about this video. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends. So thank you guys for watching. Bye bye. See you in the next video. Take care guys.